This Mass is offered for the following intentions: for the repose of the soul of Susan Sheila, offered by her family members. Thanksgiving Mass for the Holy Trinity and Mother Mary, offered by Isaac and family. For late Anthony, Abraham and Francina, offered by Isaac and family. For the souls of Reddy Arulappa and Ananya Annamma, offered by V.N. Kumar and family. For the souls of Kadikala Swami, Arukya Swami and Dr. Arukya Swami, offered by Leo Amalraj and family. For the soul of Bishop Amalnadan, offered by Leo Amalraj and family. For the souls in purgatory, offered by Leo Amalraj and family. For the soul of Christopher Dias, offered by Mario Dias and family. For the soul of R. Dominic George, offered by family members and well-wishers. For all the souls in purgatory, offered by Eugene Fernandez and family. For the souls of Alex Barreto and Basilio Joe Dias and Mario Martin, offered by Teresa Dias and family. For the souls of Salvador Martin and Natalina Martin, August Jose Dias and Ralph Francis, offered by Teresa Dias and family. Thanksgiving Mass for Infant Jesus, offered by William Joseph Dias. Thanksgiving Mass for Infant Jesus, offered by Sahaya Mary. For the souls in purgatory, offered by Marx, Francis and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Marx, Francis and family. For the good health of Father Raju Alex and Father Jeffrey, offered by John Alex and family. For the good health of Father Raju Alex, offered by Francis Reddy. Let us also pray for all our intentions and of those who have asked us to pray for. Kindly be seated.
Present here. Today we celebrate Children's Day in our parish. This day is celebrated on the anniversary of the great Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. It is celebrated as a special day to create awareness among people about the rights and education of children. This day is celebrated all around India with great enthusiasm on the 14th of November, as it brings joy and enthusiasm filled with love and affection towards one another. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, also known as Chacha Nehru, was a true friend of children and loved to play with them in his free time. And from our Holy Bible, St. Matthew in chapter 19, verse 14 says, Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." Jesus always loved children and said he would accept anyone who has a childlike heart. Therefore, it is a reminder to keep each of our hearts pure and kindled with love, without fear, anger or vengeance, so that we keep our bond with our Lord Jesus Christ. I hope all of us have a heart as a child, and therefore I wish everyone a very happy Children's Day. Thank you.
Let's all rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, as heard in the introduction, let us specially pray for all the children in our parish in a time of this kind, the pandemic. The most vulnerable and stressed community or the group, age group, is the children, because of the number of hours that they spend, whether it is for online classes or whatever. And so they need our special prayers and concern from our side. And so we offer this Eucharistic celebration in a special way for all the children of our parish. And also the scripture invites us to answer the accountability that we have given by God for all the things that we have received from Him. It could be in the form of talents, of resources, as the scripture tells us. Let us introspect ourselves. How accountable am I to the time, to the resources, and to the life that God has given to me? Let us seek God's pardon and mercy for our sins and offenses. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed you, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you. For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
First reading, a reading from the book of Proverbs, chapter 31, verses 10 to 30, 19 to 20, and 30 to 31. An excellent wife, who can find? She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hand to the poor, and reaches out her hands to the needy. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her words praise her in the gates. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm, Psalm 127. Your response is, blessed are all who fear the Lord.
Blessed are all who fear the
Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. You will be blessed and prosper. Your response, blessed are all who fear the Lord. Your wife like a fruitful vine in the heart of your house. Your children like shoots of the olive around your table. Your response?
Blessed are all who fear the Lord.
Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion. May you see Jerusalem prosper all the days of your life. Response?
Blessed are all who fear the Lord.
Let not the day of the Lord surprise you like a thief. Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 5, verses 1 to 6. Concerning the times and the seasons, brothers, you have no need to have anything written to you, for you yourself are fully aware that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them, as labor pains come upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you are not in darkness, brothers, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all children of light, children of the day. We are not of the night or of the darkness. So then, let us not sleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Acclamation.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 25, verses 14 to 30. At that time, Jesus told his disciples this parable. It will be like a man going on a journey who called his servants and entrusted to them his property. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1. To each according to his ability. Then he went away. He who had received the 5 talents went at once and traded with them, and he made 5 talents more. So also he who had the 2 talents made 2 talents more. But he who had received the 1 talent went and dug in the ground and hid his master's money. Now, after a long time, the master of those servants came and settled accounts with them. And he who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 talents more, saying, Master, you delivered to me 5 talents. Here I have made 5 talents more. His master said to him, Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master. And he also who had the 2 talents came forward saying, Master, you delivered to me 2 talents. Here I have made 2 talents more. His master said to him, Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master. He also who had received the 1 talent came forward saying, Master, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you scattered no seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours. But his master answered him, You wicked and slothful servant, you knew that I reap where I have not sown, and gather where I scattered no seed. Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and at my coming I should have received what was my own interest with. So take the talent from him and give it to him who has the 10 talents. For to everyone who has will more be given, and he will have an abundance. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And cast the worthless servant into the outer darkness. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Friends in Christ Jesus, as in the parish, we are celebrating the Children's Day. One important aspect of a child that we need to always keep in mind is the vulnerability of every child, that the child is prone to get hurt, and every parent takes keen interest that the child is not hurt in its vulnerability. And this is also what we all have. We all are vulnerable. And the Lord beautifully summarizes, the kingdom of heaven belongs to children. And as a child, when I surrender my vulnerability into the hands of God, it is He who saves me, it is He who protects me. Because Jesus Himself became a vulnerable man hanging on the cross. He opened out his hands and he showed his wounds to the people. And he said, these are the wounds through which I am going to heal you. By my wounds, you will be healed. And so to become a child is to totally surrender, to totally trust my creator, my author of life, Jesus himself. And so dear brothers and sisters, as we come at the altar, the Lord died and rose again for us, time and again informs us or invites us to come and rely in Him, and apart from Him there is no other way that we can ever flourish or grow. And so, dear brothers and sisters, let us keep this in mind, how vulnerable I am. I am always prone to get hurt. People might insult me. Sometimes even a simple word that you are short, you are dark, or you are whatever, everything hurts us. We are vulnerable creatures. And this vulnerability is not something to be sad about or cry about. This vulnerability is to accept myself as I am, the way God has created me. My existence is itself a great gift that God has given to me, and I accept my vulnerability as a child, and I always look up to my Father who created me and take refuge in Him. In a similar way, the first reading talks about a good wife, a virtuous person who always be generous towards the poor and needy and does the best use of the resources given to her. And this is also a call for all of us. How virtuous can I be? As we heard in the responsorial psalm, blessed are those who fear the Lord. Fear of the Lord is not something that we tremble or we are scared of God as a hard taskmaster. Fear of the Lord is a beginning of wisdom, as the scripture tells us, where we are aware, as I said, that my Creator is totally in charge of me. And so I owe my life, I owe everything that I have. And so my actions have to glorify Him through whatever I do. To become virtuous is to begin these initial steps of learning to obey the Lord in our day-to-day living as such. And as St. Paul very beautifully summarizes the end times calls us to be prepared. In fact, the present situations in the modern world is that if there is a theft happening, within hours the police is able to capture, because Hyderabad is one of those cities which has more than 2 lakhs or whatever number, huge number of CCTVs are there. So no one can escape a thief. But invariably we know no thief informs you and comes to your home, which means to say we need to be always prepared with the resources that we have, that we need to be ready for the coming of the Lord, for the arrival of the Lord. It can be my own death. The day I die is the day I meet the Lord, is the end times for me. And so the question that arises me, if today is my last day, if my life ends today, how prepared I am? And this is the question that St. Paul puts into our hearts. How prepared are you? How prepared am I in these end times? Are you ready to meet the Lord? Are you ready to give an answer to the questions of the Lord? In fact, after 25th chapter of Matthew, we have that episode where feed the hungry, giving drink to the thirsty, all these things come. What I have done with my life is being answered in that. And when we come to this gospel parable, the parable is generally, we understand, as a story which is open-ended. There's no precise message given, but we need to think, we need to reflect about it. And many insights can come over. The Lord can inspire us through these little parables. And so the story starts with the man. It doesn't mention him as a king or as a big businessman. It just tells a man going on a journey. Now, who is this man in the parable? And the next sentence is about servants, slaves, who owe everything to their master. Unlike the times that we are today, that free society, there was always a slavery was an important part, where a servant, a slave is owned by people. They're literally sealed by the master's name. So wherever they go, they know this is a slave of particular family or particular clan as such. And so this master entrusts some important things to these slaves. And as we all know, the word talent over here is not the special ability to perform some fine arts. The word talent over here refers to a huge amount of money. It could be like a bond paper with so much of amount. So that can be exchanged for a greater price. Roughly, they say it could be like $1,000 or in Indian currency, maybe somewhere close to 75 or 1 lakh, something like that. So a huge amount of money or the amount is given to these slaves. Each one is given according to their abilities. Now here, if we pause and reflect, that the slaves are given talents according to their abilities. We need to always reflect and understand this. God knows what is best for me. Sometimes we wonder at the blessings that God has given. Sometimes we are very negative or pessimistic. Why did God not give me? There was one man, as you all might have seen that video of Mr. Nick from Australia. He had no limbs. At one point of time, at the age of 8, he decided to commit suicide because what is the purpose of my life with no hands and no legs? And that's where he was struck with the word of God, which said in the Gospel according to John, "It is I who give glory to you, whether you have hands or legs. My glory is revealed in you." So you are a perfect human being, whether you have any part of your body or no. I am there to glorify myself and give glory to you as you are with what you have. And so we need to acknowledge what God has given to us according to my own need and my own ability. And God knows what is best for me. Perhaps we fail to understand this and end up making a big mistake of our lives when I start comparing myself with others. He's so handsome, she's so beautiful, they have a very big house, they have this. And that comparison is where a direct negation or denial of what God has given to me, I am rejecting it. I don't want what you have given me, I want what I want. No, God has given me plenty, what is sufficient for me. I need to discover it. It might be 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, even at the age of 80, as Abraham was able to accept him at such an elderly age. He accepted the call of God and he acknowledged what he had and he became the father of faith. And so when we acknowledge the primary thing, the first thing that should come to us is to be grateful. How grateful I am with what I have. This is very important because if I am not grateful, I am taking things for granted. Sometimes my own mom might be there at home, my dad, my spouse, my children. I might take everyone for granted till the day they are no more. After that, oh, I should have spent some more time with them. Oh, he was a very great man. If only I had some more time or some more occasion that I could have spent with them. There's no use. Acknowledge and be grateful to the people around, to the things that we have right now, every day. And perhaps as we are coming closer to the end of this liturgical year, as we are going to enter Advent very soon, maybe towards the end of the year on the midnight vigil on the new year, we will be giving thanksgiving in the church, in our own homes. Start writing a small little notes of gratitude towards the people who meant a lot. Maybe to your own uncle, auntie, or friends who made a big difference. And that little note would express your gratefulness to them. And also spend every day in your life to be grateful to God for what He is constantly giving. We have come across from March to this month without being touched. Sometimes maybe even if we have got affected by this pandemic, the Lord is still protecting us. The Lord is still giving us this good health, and we need to acknowledge and be grateful to that. And that is where we need to, when the parable tells that each one is given according to their ability. This is an important aspect of our Christian faith. An ungrateful heart is literally closed to receive any blessing. I don't have anything. That's where all kinds of negativity starts in us, all kinds of pessimism starts in us. There's nothing in future. Everything is going to collapse. Everything is going to end. If there is no gratitude in my heart, this is what I end up with. And secondly, when the man who goes out, he doesn't say how long he goes out. He comes back from his journey and there is an account being asked. They are asked to show their accountability with whatever they have been given. We all have been given with so many resources, with so many talents, with so many gifts. It could be our own family, it could be our job, it could be everything that we have been receiving all this while. And every day or every now and then, it is good for us to look back and say, Lord, this is what you have given me and this is what I've been doing. And this is what happens in prayer. Prayer is not merely about conversation about pouring out about my burdens, prayer is also my answer to the question that God asks about accountability. 24 hours a day, 365 days, and so many good people around you, your parents, your well-wishers, some people who have hurt you, even that can be a learning experience for us. All these things, and how have I made use of all these resources, is an important question that we need to ask every day in our prayer. Gratitude and accountability becomes an essential part of our living Christian spiritual life through the scriptures that we have. And finally, towards the end, you're a good and faithful servant, you come and enjoy the kingdom with me. That faithfulness is also demanded from every Christian soul, from every Christian person. Faithfulness, even when it is not possible, even when it is very difficult, because this faithfulness of ours is not rooted on our own ability to always abide by the Lord. This faithfulness of ourselves is rooted in the very faithfulness of God Himself, because He says, I will never give up on you. I always would like to narrate this episode from the Old Testament. There was one time Abraham was asked to make a covenant with God, and the Lord says, you divide or cut an animal, head separate and trunk separate. And with that kind of generally when the covenant takes place, two kings walk in between that, between head and body of an animal, to show if I, as they cross by, they will say these words, if I don't keep up this covenant, let this happen to me, which means to say, if I don't abide by the command or covenant, let my head be chopped off, let me be made into two. But interestingly, in that portion of the Bible, we see Abraham was told by God, you don't need to go through that. I will go and tell you that even if you are not faithful, I will always remain faithful to you. This covenant abides forever and ever. I will never break away this covenant with you. This is my promise. This is my promise of faithfulness to you. And so this faithful God invites us today that in however hard circumstances, especially the times that we are going through, things may not be working in our favor at all. Finance, no job, family disputes, and several other factors, the way injustice is happening around. All these difficult situations calls us to become more loyal, to become more faithful to the one who created us. He who has brought us to this far will also lead us to the pastures that are green. And that is what we read in the Psalm 23, even in the darkest valley, His staff and His crook is by my side. And so the call for faithfulness, to always adhere, to abide by the Christian law, by the Christian values, is the call that we receive from this parable today. And so, dear brothers and sisters, let us remember that we all are vulnerable. We all are vulnerable to be hurt, and it is God who is going to heal us. And we are called to be grateful, accountable, and faithful in the presence of God. Let us all rise and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, and was buried, he descended into hell, on the third day he rose again from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, life everlasting. Amen. The man goes on a journey, has entrusted his servants enough talents and sufficient amount of time to do what they wish with them. Two of them are successful, but one utterly fails, that we too may put the resources at our disposal to the best use. We pray, Lord, make our lives fruitful.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that as leaders in the church, they may encourage the faithful to use their gifts and talents to the best of their ability. We pray. For all women, that the work they do at home, at their workplaces, and in their parishes may be appreciated and rewarded. We pray.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
That women may not be exploited in any way, that they may not become victims of abuse and not be made victims of physical and emotional violence. We pray.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
That all human beings created in the image and likeness of God, who is the perfect worker, that each of them may put to God use the gifts and talents received from God. We pray.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that enlightened by the word of God, we may become like the servants who are able to multiply them, thus having brought joy to the Master. We pray.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
Dear Lord Jesus, during this Holy Eucharist, we are celebrating our children. This year has been an unusual year for the whole world. Whoever thought that the lives of all the people in the world would be turned topsy-turvy by a tiny little virus? Everyone is affected in some way or the other, and more so the little children. They have been forced to stay indoors, not meet their friends, study online, and walk thousands of miles with their parents, and in some cases, not even hug and kiss their parents or loved ones. It's a very confusing time for all, and it is not easy for children to understand why all this is happening. Protect all the children, Lord, and give patience to all the adults who take care of them. Rid the world of this virus soon, so that the world can go back to normal and the children get back to their childhood. We pray.
Amen.
Silently pray for our personal and community needs. God our Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son Jesus, who has taught us that positive attitude towards work is rewarded while laziness and its justification are severely condemned. Give us the grace that we may put our abilities to the best use, thereby giving praise to your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May God accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and for the good of His church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by His birth He brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by suffering cancelled out our sins. By His rising from the dead, He has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, He has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises without end, we acclaim. Disciples, so now for us, He opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before He was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, He took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Bala, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant us also, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, with the Apostles, Martyrs, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God and glory of God, and our forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. This is Jesus, the giver of all the gifts, and who invites us to be faithful. Blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be called.
you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
near God is my happiness, to place my hope in God the Lord. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated. The church notices today, the 33rd Sunday in ordinary time. Feast of this week, 17th, is a memorial of St. Elizabeth of Hungary, 18th, memory of dedication of basilicas of Peter and Paul, 21st is the memory of the presentation of Mary. We continue to stream the Masses online on Facebook and YouTube with the title of Holy Trinity Church, Begumpet. Kindly be at home and be safe. Pray daily for protection from coronavirus. Continue to pray for our parish priest, Reverend Father Raju Alex, for his good health. Last Sunday's collection was ₹4,960. The parish community thanks you for your generosity. Kindly rise for the final blessing.
The Lord be with you.
Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.